Blackstone presents Illuminations, Essays and Reflections by Walter Benjamin, translated by Harry Zohn, edited and with an introduction by Hannah Arendt. This book is read by Stefan Rudnicki. Introduction. Walter Benjamin, 1892-1940. 1. The Hunchback. Fama, that much coveted goddess, has many faces, and fame comes in many sorts and sizes, from the one-week notoriety of the cover story to the splendor of an everlasting name. Posthumous fame is one of Fama's rarer and least desired articles, although it is less arbitrary and often more solid than the other sorts, since it is only seldom bestowed upon mere merchandise. The one who stood most to profit is dead, and hence it is not for sale. Such posthumous fame, uncommercial and unprofitable, has now come in Germany to the name and work of Walter Benjamin, Walter Benjamin, a German-Jewish writer who was known, but not famous, as a contributor to magazines and literary sections of newspapers for less than 10 years prior to Hitler's seizure of power and his own emigration. There were few who still knew his name when he chose death in those early fall days of 1940, which for many of his origin and generation marked the darkest moment of the war. The fall of France, the threat to England, the still intact Hitler-Stalin Pact, whose most feared consequence at that moment was the close cooperation of the two most powerful secret police forces in Europe. 15 years later, a 2-volume edition of his writings was published in Germany and brought him almost immediately a succès d'estime that went far beyond the recognition among the few which he had known in his life. And since mere reputation, however high, as it rests on the judgment of the best, is never enough for writers and artists to make a living that only fame, the testimony of a multitude which need not be astronomical in size, can guarantee, one is doubly tempted to say with Cicero, "Si vivi vicissent, qui morte viserunt," how different everything would have been if they had been victorious in life who have won victory in death. Posthumous fame is too odd a thing to be blamed upon the blindness of the world or the corruption of a literary milieu. Nor can it be said that it is the bitter reward of those who were ahead of their time, as though history were a racetrack on which some contenders run so swiftly that they simply disappear from the spectator's range of vision. On the contrary, posthumous fame is usually preceded by the highest recognition among one's peers. When Kafka died in 1924, his few published books had not sold more than a couple of hundred copies, but his literary friends and the few readers who had almost accidentally stumbled on the short prose pieces, none of the novels was as yet published, knew beyond doubt that he was one of the masters of modern prose. Walter Benjamin had won such recognition early, and not only among those whose names at that time were still unknown, such as Gerhard Scholem, the friend of his youth, and Theodor Wiesengrund Adorno, his first and only disciple, who together are responsible for the posthumous edition of his works and letters. Immediate, instinctive, one is tempted to say, recognition came from Hugo von Hofmannsthal, who published Benjamin's essay on Goethe's elective affinities in 1924, and from Bertolt Brecht, who upon receiving the news of Benjamin's death is reported to have said that this was the first real loss Hitler had caused to German literature. We cannot know if there is such a thing as altogether unappreciated genius, or whether it is the daydream of those who are not geniuses, but we can be reasonably sure that posthumous fame will not be their lot. Fame is a social phenomenon. Ad gloriam non est satis unius opinio, as Seneca remarked wisely and pedantically. For fame, the opinion of one is not enough, although it is enough for friendship and love. And no society can properly function without classification, without an arrangement of things and men in classes and prescribed types. This necessary classification.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.